Ask yourself, what did I do today? The good deeds, you say Alhamdulillah. If you made mistake, ask forgiveness on daily basis. So if you don't allocate time for self-inventory, your heart will get sick. Second thing, being unrealistic. You just keep living in the world of fantasy. Many people live in fantasy. They are not here in this life. They're just always living in another world, fantasizing. For instance, inshallah, I will be a good Muslim when I become old man, or after marriage, or after doing Hajj. This person is dreaming as if he has a guarantee that he will live until that time. You can die anytime, man. Wake up. Go to the graveyard and see the graves. How old is he? 5 years, 10 years, 15 years, 20 years? Young men are dying. Do you think you will live until you... Not only this, many people, they carry on fantasizing, deceiving themselves. When they are already on the verge of the grave, they have gray hair, like me. The gray hair, this is the sign, indication. And you find still, he is dreaming. Don't you know that Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, the span of my ummah is from 60 to 70. That's the average. If you are now 50, let's say that you will live up to 60. You have only 10 years remain. That's it. Nothing more. So do something. Wake up. If you are 60, now if something, it's only bonus. Okay? You should expect the visitor anytime. The visitor, the death, anytime will knock your door. It's over. Oh, I'm not ready. No way. So that's what destroys your heart. Procrastination, tomorrow, 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 and tomorrow never comes. You keep procrastinating. I'll do it later. I'll do this. That is from the shaitan. Also, among the things that weakens, makes the heart weak, is to rely upon other than Allah. To have tawakkul not on Allah. You don't trust Allah. You don't rely on Allah. You don't depend on Allah. You depend upon other than Allah. Then, if you depend upon other than Allah and rely upon other than Allah, then this heart will be sick heart. You know, if you want your heart to remain firm, put your trust in Allah. Then you will not fear anyone but Allah. Read in the Quran. فَلَمَّ تَرَاءَ الْجَمْعَانِ قَالَ أَصْحَابُ مُوسَىٰ إنا لمدركون قال كلا إن معي ربي سيهدين. The Quran tells us that when Musa alayhi salam, he took the Israelites, Banu Israel, from Egypt, and then the king of Egypt, the Pharaoh, and his troops followed them. When the day started to break, the troops of the Pharaoh behind the Musa and his people, and the sea in front of them. So they are sandwiched. There's no way to escape, true or not. So the people of Musa said, oh Musa, we are finished. We'll be taken, we'll be captured. Musa said, nay, no way. They cannot catch us. What are you talking? They're behind us. He said, no way. Kalla, nay. Inna ma'ya rabbi sayahdeen. Verily, I have my Lord with me. I have Allah with me. He's the one who's going to save me. And what happened? وَنَّظْرِبْ بِعَصَاكَ الْبَحْرِ. Hit the sea with your stick and staff. And what happened? And the sea split. This is the tawakkul. When the heart relies upon Allah, nothing shakes it. Nothing. Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wasallam, when he migrated from Mecca to Medina, and the mushriks, they made a prize whoever brings Muhammad dead or alive, 100 she-camel. And one guy who's an expert in reading the footprints followed them. His name was Suraq ibn Malik. And he followed the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Abu Bakr as-Siddiq said, "Oh Prophet of Allah, someone is after us." He said, "Don't worry." And what happened? The land was so rocky. It's a rocky land. It's not moor land, rocky land. And the two hands and the two legs of the horse sank into the rocky land. So the horse fell down. The rider also fell off. And then he jumped. And he tried to do this to follow the Prophet and to catch the Prophet. And it happened to him 3 times. Then the Prophet ﷺ turned to him, said, "Suraqa, don't waste your time. You cannot catch us. Allah is our protector. Don't waste time. But I will tell you something, Suraqa. Go back and I will promise you to give you the bangles, the bracelets of the king of Persia." Can you imagine the Prophet ﷺ is chased, wanted, and he's promising the bangles, the bracelets of the emperor of Persia? And the years passed and Islam spread. And Suraqa became a Muslim. And during the Khilafah, the reign of Umar ibn Khattab, the Muslims took Persia and they brought the bangles, the bracelets of the king of Persia, the emperor. And Umar ibn Khattab said, "Where is Suraqa ibn Malik? Stand up, give me your hands. This is what the Prophet promised you." So this is the tawakkul. He's telling him, "Go. You cannot do anything to us because we were just in the cave and you couldn't see us in the cave." And by the way, brothers and sisters, when they were in the cave, there was no web spider. There was no web spider. There was no pigeon, nothing. It is the power of Allah who protected them. The cave was open. Nothing is there. As Abu Bakr said, "If one just did like this, he will be able to see us." The Prophet told him, "Don't worry, they will not be see us. They will not be able to see us because Allah is protecting us." Also, what sickens and what will make the heart sick is too much of eating. If you eat too much, you will sleep too much. And if you sleep too much, you will miss a lot. You will miss good deeds, many things. The actions of the heart. The first thing among the actions of the heart is learning and understanding. You learn by your heart and you understand by your heart. As Allah said, أَفَلَمْ يَسِيرُوا فِي الْأَرْضِ فَتَكُونَ لَهُمْ قُلُوبٌ يَعْقِلُونَ بِهَا أَوْ آذَانٌ يَسْمَعُونَ بِهَا. Do they not travel through the land so that their hearts may thus learn wisdom? Their hearts learn wisdom and their ears may thus learn to hear. So the hearts, they learn. The heart learns. As just the heart gets blind, the heart learns as well. Among the actions of the heart, brothers and sisters, is love. How do you love someone? By your ear? Your tongue? By which of the 5 senses? No. By your heart. That's why you see the teenagers' hearts everywhere, right? And on Valentine's Day, Valentine's Day is the day of the hearts. Pink, everyone is pink. Hearts. And your hearts, you see the arrow through the heart, right? That is, they call it Cupid arrow. So people, they love by their hearts. And you feel the pain in your heart, right? Have you experienced that, brothers? I'm sure many of you, those who loved, they experienced that pain in their hearts, right? So you love by your heart. So that is also one of the acts of the heart. Also among the actions of the heart is hatred. This heart, you love and you hate. You say, "Ya akhi, I hate him. I don't like him." You hate with what? With your heart.